Welcome to another follow-up video, in fact, with Marcel Punt, the author of The Strawberry Code. I can say that just publishing this video, as with the publication of your book or your study on the actually metronome problem, so to say, about Strawberry, has made some thoughts on the internet, on Facebook, and so it might be a good idea, we thought, just to have a follow-up video to address some concerns that people have on some questions and just go over some elements. So Marcel, welcome here again. It's great to have you. So let's just dive into some elements. If I go back to my field of research, my period, so Beethoven, Mozart, and Czerny, that period, Moscheles, those fast movement metronome numbers rarely are ever possible in single beats. So I sometimes wonder, what are we talking about? But how is that with Reger? Are his metronome numbers technically possible in single beat? And are people actually playing according to that?
I know one example where the metronome marks are played according to single beat. And that is Rosalinde Haas. Yes, it's not like with Czerny that you get simply too many notes per second. So in that perspective, yes, it's not impossible technically, but musically it is.
You have given a quote or given about Gotcher. Maybe that's needs for some explanation, because that's really tying into Reger.
Well, Gatsche was a student of both Strauber and Reger.
Okay.
And he is writing about the, well, evidently about the Strauber editions.
Which context is he writing, explaining what to who?
Well, he is saying that there are there is a risk for large misunderstandings concerning the tempo by Reger, and that in his editions Strauber has made the problem clear.
Okay.
And then he the reason for that he uses a word, Notationsgrundlage.
Yeah,
which,
the foundation of notation.
Yeah, it's the basis of the notation.
And which time is this writing?
So Gatsche writes in 1924. I will first read it in German. Die Regerschen Tempobezeichnungen konnten zu Missverständnissen führen, die in ihrer katastrophalen Auswirkung kaum auszudenken sind. Straubers Interpretation hat von vornherein Klarheit geschaffen, die Tempofrage führt kaum mehr zu einer folgenschweren Verwirrung, da die Notationsgrundlage erkannt ist. This would be in English. The tempo indications by Reger could lead to misunderstandings which in their catastrophic effect are barely to imagine. Strauber's interpretation has at the outset provided clarification. The tempo issue leads hardly any more to a serious confusion since the notational basis has been perceived.
I remember having seen a comment someone made that Gatsche is actually not talking about at all on the metronome numbers.
You can't explain it otherwise, the term Notationsgrundlage. In Gatsche's explanation, because he says that it's the notational basis that makes it all clear. It's the basis of the notation that Strauber has changed. Only the note values of the metronome marks are changed. And of course, well, yeah, a 60 might become a 72, or a 72 might become a 63, but those are just very marginal differences, and that we can ascribe to personal interpretative decisions. Nobody plays like a metronome, and of course we don't need to adhere to metronome marks totally. Exactly, not literally. It's also an acoustical thing. It can depend on your mood and everything. But let's face it, we can't make a 200% change just like that.
Interesting, Marcel, to bring this point up of Gatsche. I think that's a really important point that we missed in the previous interview. So I can only say again, this is not the last word that has been written and spoken about this, and let's hope that it opens some people's minds and just taking a step back and have some distance to the facts, and even if it's not according to your own taste or it's no problem. I mean, we are living in a free world, everybody plays music like he or she wants, and that's not the thing that at least I don't think you want to influence or just change things, but just inspire people, and we share our experiences and journey of research. That's in fact what we do. So thank you, Marcel, for making time for this follow-up video, and probably there will be another one, who knows. So hope to see you soon again.
Okay. Bye. Thank you. Bye.